had to save ourselves. Mm-hmm. And when the storms came through, they found me and you back together. And when the sun would shine, it was yours and mine. Thought they had us done. We came around, yeah. How we rolled and rambled. We got lost, we got found. Now we're back on solid ground, yeah. We took everything all our time would bring in this world of dangers. 'Cause when your heart, you know you're not alone in this world of strangers. Know how the years go by. Oh, how the love brings tears to my eyes. All through the changes, the soul never dies. We fight, we laugh, we cry as the years go by.
Children, what have you?
Children.
Yeah.
You?
Yeah,
I'm going back to the day you remember Amherst's park didn't line up for
Matt, send it, go in key.
Let's have a Matt to bring it in.
Bring it in.
Oh.
Do something.
What are you going to say?
You
say.
Cut their fingers.
Amen, hallelujah. Portage rolls like, on three.
No.
Amen. Class 97.
Let me throw on your
arms. Class 97.
One, two, three.
Class 97 rocks!
Watch the step.
Ah, yeah, there you go.
Watch the step.
Hey,
how are we doing?
Hey,
don't go into the
light. Don't go into the
light.
And destruction!
What?
He's got a great
voice. Oh, yeah, just great. Very lovely. We all like it. Go, Kara!
He just got his hair cut. He wants to show it off.
Right out. It's the same haircut.
Same
Oh my God!
Hi there, how are you?
Fine, how are you?
Ready the gadget, eh?
Yeah, we're ready.
Let's do it.
Hey, my brother's down there.
What?
My brother's down there.
Where?
Right there. He's my brother.
Oh, yeah, we said that.
4 minutes. 4 minutes
and
counting. 4 minutes.
How you doing?
4 minutes. Good. How about you?
Bright light.
That's better.
Brian, do you remember saying these words? Do you remember when you graduated? Do you, Brian? Do you remember it?
Does anybody remember me? Please?
What's up, Dad? How are we doing, eh?
Hi.
Go on the roof. Oh.
Yes.
Hey, how are we doing?
Good.
Hi there. Is she voted like most shy in the class or what?
I don't know.
No? Who's ready to go? Okay.
This is gay.
Oh, we're back. Part two. Class of 97 rules, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's gay, though.
Oh, wait, you're in row three. Hi, guys. How are you doing?
Matt.
Do you think they know what they're doing now? They do. You're sure? Very good.
Isn't that just great? We
get
to do
it. No, there wasn't Mike. Mike didn't do it.
He didn't do it.
He's guilty.
Hi. How are we doing here, huh? 3 minutes and counting.
Yeah.
He looks so excited.
2 minutes and counting, and we're leaving now, so see you later.
Bye.
Bye.
You're out of here. Hey.
I had a superintendent.
Hey, we're ready to roll here.
Brett, go.
Hey, let's go. Say goodbye.
I don't want to do this.
Hey, you're history.
We're history. We're about to make it.
There you go.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please rise to the Pledge of Allegiance and the flame of our national anthem? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Let us pray. Lord God, centuries ago, your servant Moses led your chosen people to the promised land, instructing and teaching them. He was not to enter that land himself, but entrusted that people to others to face the challenge of life in a new land. That land of promise was also a land of challenge. The people had to make it their own through work and effort to fulfill its promise. Many met the challenge. Others did not. We come together now as your people, facing the new land of promise that lies before us. These parents and teachers have brought these young people to this point, instructing and leading them. Like Moses, they will not cross over into that future with them, but must entrust them to others. As with your people of old, these young men and women face a future of challenge, of uncertainty. They face it with hope, but also concern. We ask that you be with them and protect them. Give them courage and perseverance, that the lessons they have learned may be fruitful for them. Fill them with the joy of your presence, and let their lives be examples of your peace and love. We ask this in the name of Jesus, your Son, in the power of your Holy Spirit. Amen.
Clergy, administration, school board members, faculty, parents, relatives, and friends. The class of 1997 welcomes you to the 49th annual commencement exercise at the Portage Area School District. Tonight is a time of endings and beginnings. As we sit before you on this stage, we remember the events of our high school years. We have accomplished so much and now enjoy the pride of our achievements, as well as the memories of our involvement and the friendships started in our high school activities. We share these memories with you, for you helped in making these memories, some of you by being personally involved, while others simply by giving support to our hopes and aspirations. We thank you for all you have done. But as our high school years close tonight, another door opens for us, the door leading to the future. Again, you have helped us by providing the knowledge and guidance that are the keys that unlock this door. And though we must continue this journey on our own, your presence still remains, and your instruction will be our foundation. We will do our best with what you have instilled in us and promise to pass this knowledge to the next generation. Wish us well for the rest of life's journey, because we couldn't have made it this far without you. Thank you.
What is success? To laugh often and much? To win the respect of intelligent people and the affection of children? To earn the appreciation of honest critics and endure the betrayal of false friends? To appreciate beauty? To find the best in others? To leave the world a bit better, whether by a healthy child, a garden patch, or a redeemed social condition? To know even one life has breathed easier because you have lived? That is to have succeeded. Success can be measured in many ways, and I am sure that all who sit here tonight have succeeded in some way at some time. Whether the results were as small as coloring inside the lines in elementary school, or as monumental as putting on our caps and gowns this evening, we have only just begun. After tonight, we will be moving on, away from the structured environment of school, into the realm of the real world. This is when we should keep in mind Emerson's quote, "To laugh often and much." I was always taught that laughter was the best medicine. Experience confirmed it. What more can be said? To be happy is to be successful. To win the respect of intelligent people and the affection of children, one can travel far with respect. If you are respected, you have succeeded in proving your greatness and wealth to others. The affection of children may be as easily lost as it is gained. When gained, it proves a treasure. If you are lucky enough to be admired by a youngster, do not belittle it. Success lies in small places, a smiling face perhaps. To earn the appreciation of honest critics and endure the betrayal of false friends. A little constructive criticism never hurts. Everyone's a critic. Conducting yourself in a manner to earn appreciation is a sure sign of maturity and a definite precursor to a lifetime of success. Endurance of betrayal may be the most difficult aspect of Emerson's idea to accomplish, yet we often learn this when we least expect it. To find the best in others. It is easy to find fault, but when you recognize the worth in someone, you have found a treasure. A diamond in the rough, perhaps. But everyone has worth. When we believe this, our lives will take on an entirely new perspective. Only then will we truly see a person, and in turn, honestly see ourselves. To appreciate beauty. When we can view ourselves for what we truly are, we can begin to appreciate the little things that lie deep within everything and everyone. Finding the beauty most of the time is finding the good. Finding the beauty may take some time and patience, but remember, it is not only skin deep. To leave the world a bit better, whether by a healthy child, a garden patch, or a redeemed social condition. Who knows what this outstanding group of people will accomplish? The cure for cancer? Nurturing a child? Planting a tree? The opportunities are endless, but open to all of us. All we have to do is accept the offer and be brave enough to see it through. To know even one life has breathed easier because you have lived. Your parents, your best friend, the woman you helped the other day, or the man you will cheerfully say hello to tomorrow would not and will not have had the opportunity to experience that bit of joy without you. If you have helped even one person smile or appreciate himself a little more, continue it, because this particular statement may mean the most. Success is not a self-centered idea, but a shared and proud feeling. That is to have succeeded. Tonight, we all have succeeded, and tomorrow, we will begin to succeed again. Thank you.
Thank you. We would now like to recognize our foreign exchange students. Helen Schultz is from Vitterud, Sweden. She's been staying with Mr. and Mrs. Trashko and Brooke Matheson. Diego Orishi is from Chiba, Japan. She has been staying with the Faulkners. Gold, what is it? It's a precious metal. It's a standard by which we base all others. It's purity. It's 14 karat. It's the best, the ultimate to strive to obtain, the ultimate for which to seek. And the gold in our lives, what is it? We have all heard that our teenage years are the best years of our lives. What exactly does that mean? What was it about these past few years that have made them so special to each and every one of us? What of these years have been precious, have been of value? What of these years have been golden? I propose the gold in our lives has first been family. Our families are the people who have always stood by us, no matter what. To them, it didn't matter if we took second. It only mattered that we tried and gave it our best. Families are the people we can count on to help us through the situations and problems when we thought we could not go on. Without them, we would have never turned into the young adults you see before you tonight. They taught us our morals and our sense of integrity. Our pride and self-confidence comes from them. Our families are there as our foundation, giving us our roots, making us secure, giving us the courage to take wing and fly. Our families are the gold standard by which we base the rest of our lives. I propose the gold in our lives has secondly been friends. Make new friends, but keep the old. One is silver, the other gold. Friends are the people who know you better than you know yourself, and still like you anyway. They cheer us up when we're feeling blue, and always know just what to say in those sticky situations when words seem to be gone. They say, you can count on me, without uttering a word. Thirdly, I propose the gold in our lives is our memories. Memories help us to record the special moments that we never want to forget, like our first high school formal or your sweet 16, the great times at homecoming, senior night, or playoff games, the crazy times with friends at concerts, hustles, or just a night out. Memories take on many different forms, yet all these forms live in our hearts. They become the framework around which the rest of our lives evolve. Our aspirations and dreams round out the last ingredient to the gold in our lives. Solomon in the Old Testament said, "When there is no vision, the people perish. Without hope, without dreams, life becomes staid and dull. As gold is the ultimate to strive for, so should our dreams and goals be. Golden, a bright, shining ray, pulling us onward, calling us forward to greater heights, greater challenges, greater rewards." Louisa May Alcott wrote, "Far away there in the sunshine are my highest aspirations. I may not reach them, but I can look up and see their beauty, believe in them, and try to follow where they lead." Our families, our friends, our memories have been in our past and in our present, but our dreams and our aspirations, they become our future. A future that is only limited by the limitations that we place on it. A future that is the wide unknown. A future that is a clean slate for each of us to write our own separate stories. Burton Bailey has written, "The best verse hasn't been rhymed yet. The best house hasn't been planned. The highest peak hasn't been climbed yet. The mightiest rivers aren't spanned. Don't worry and fret faint-hearted. The chances have just begun. For the best jobs haven't been started, the best work hasn't been done." The gold in our lives is here with us tonight, our family, our friends, our memories, and to these we say thank you. The gold in our future, however, is ours for the taking, is ours for the dreaming, is ours for the living.
Throughout our years of high school, we have been faced with many challenges, each having its own degree of difficulty, ranging from a test, a final exam, or just dealing with a dispute between our friends. We have made decisions each time, whether right or wrong, learning from each experience. I remember that in eighth grade, I would worry about what to wear or when to get my homework done. As I grew older, I realized which was more important to me. Everyone did. Something always had a little more importance to each of us, and it wasn't always going to be the same answer. We had to figure out what was best at the time and simply do it. At this time, we began to set priorities. What we thought was best often was not. We all learned. Each of us started to create our own value system based on our beliefs and with the help of others in our lives. High school taught us more than academics. It helped us develop as individuals in the security of friends and family. The choices we made, whether we liked it or not, were going to affect our lives in some way. I know for myself, I was always busy with sports, academics, and so-called having a life. Many times I had to choose whether to go out or to get my work done. I could always, without a doubt, hear my parents in the background saying, "You better get your priorities straight." I'm sure many of my classmates heard something similar. This guidance may not have been popular at the time, but ultimately we recognized the concern of those involved. We all had to decide what we wanted to achieve in school and what was important to us. We had to do what was best and not what someone else wanted us to do. Setting our priorities early in the school year so that things would get accomplished was extremely important. I'm sure my priorities were different from others, but I had to have the courage to stand by my beliefs. Most often someone would say, "Why do you waste your time doing that?" To me, my time is not wasted, but put into my thoughts and ideas in order to accomplish my goals. Like everyone graduating tonight, I have begun to realize my priorities as I plan for the future. As a group, we must realize whatever our priorities are, we must have the courage to pursue them and the strength to support them. If our priority proves to be misguided, then we must have the responsibility to recognize it and to correct it. Blaming someone else is fooling ourselves, for ultimately we are responsible for ourselves and our choices. As graduating seniors, we must recognize this and welcome it as a sign of maturity. Graduation indicates more than academic accomplishment. It recognizes personal growth. At this time, we begin to make our own decisions and focus on our lives. Priorities will now reveal the true persons we are. Education alone does not make a person a success. Choices create success. We must recognize priorities and have the courage to challenge the future. Tonight is our beginning. Thank you.
As president of the Portage Area Senior Class of 1997, I place this plaque, which symbolizes all that is proper and good in our school, in your care. Your class must now be the one that upholds the ideals and continues the pride which have always been displayed by the student body of this fine institution.
Thank you, Brian. As president of the class of 1998, I accept the symbolic plaque. We are aware of the responsibilities that accompany it, as well as the tradition of excellence represented by the plaque. On behalf of the class of 1998, I would like to congratulate all the seniors here this evening and wish them the very best. Thank you.
Before I have the high honors and honors, I have a few remarks to make. First of all, there's a lot of people that put these graduation programs together, and I would like to thank them. If I miss anybody, I want to apologize. Mrs. Kenny, Mrs. Boucher, Mrs. Jenkins, Mr. Conlon, Mrs. Kick, the teachers, Mr. Yetsko and his secretary, Mrs. Verkevic, Mr. Bernazzoli, Mr. Black, and Mrs. Bernazzoli. We certainly couldn't have this without the cooperation of our school board. They're doing an outstanding job in this community. And of course you, all the parents. This is a really exciting day for all of you, and certainly for all these students. And I want to say that it's been a pleasure this year, and I really mean this, working with these students. This has been an outstanding class with real leaders. I mean, not only from the high honor students and the honor students, but from the average students and so on. They've just been a group of kids that are go-getters. When you needed something, they've done it. And for you students, I'm not going to give you any more positive attitude type of remarks today. But I do want to say that I know that you're all going to be very, very successful. And I want to kind of leave it with a poem that I picked up. And it's an anonymous poem, although I have a friend out in the audience by the name of Bill Plyko who has told me he knows, you know, who wrote this poem, but he's probably going to wait till after the program to tell me. But anyway, if you listen carefully, you can understand what it's saying. And it says, I took a piece of living clay and gently formed it day by day and molded with my press and art a young child's soft and yielding heart. I came again when years were gone. It was a man, woman I looked upon. He, she still early impressed wore, and I could change it nevermore. It took a piece of plastic clay and idly fashioned it one day. And as my fingers pressed it still, I moved and yielded to my will. I came again when days were past. The fill of clay was hard at last. The form I gave it still bore, but I could not change the form no more. So, students, you're ready to go, ready to set your goals, and you're going to go far, and I'm really proud of you. Thank you very much. And now for the high honors, and they're going to stand up, and you can hold your applause till they all stand up. First, Nicole Bernarski, Amy Cadwalder, Matthew Cafasso, Adrian Feathers, Alicia Handel, Matt Hodge, Shannon Ritz, Sarah Cattell, Julie Costin, Heather Moyer, Colin Durko, Ann Rank, Brianne Rogers, Helen Schultz, Tracy Serbian, and Krista Vassis. Let's give them a big hand. And now for our honors. Stacy Bolvin, Jennifer Borley, Krista Budabar, Jamie Krischko, Jason Clinton, Alan Dubrick, Matthew Elshin, Sheila Ennity, Tim Ennity, Cassie Frommel, Matthew Gentile, Christopher Kapuska, Jamie Kissel, Jennifer Koningsberg, Matt Portage, Stacy Costin, Melissa Leisinger, Lisa Lytle, Aaron Milius, Janine Molnar, Alicia Nickel, Rico Oshie, Gregory Verdrosky, John Raycar, Teddy Raycar, Heather Roberts, Carrie Shepard, Solitaire Shepard, Breanne Shope, Sam Stevens, Jennifer Vrabel, Claire Wagner, and Brian Wax-Munsky. Give them a big hand. Thank you very much. Now I'd like to present the class of 1997 to our superintendent, Mr. Jerome Yetzko.
Thank you, Dr. Cattell, Reverend clergy, members of the Board of Education, members of the faculty and administrators, honored guests, parents, and members of the graduating class. It is an honor to recognize the top five members of the class of 1997 with a Board of School Directors plaque. Will the top five please come forward as your name is called? Julia Ann Costin, valedictorian. Kyle John Ondurko, salutatorian. Anne Marie Rank. Amy Beth Cadwalder. Sarah Jean Cattell. I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate the class of 1997 seated here on stage, and also congratulations are in order for your parents and relatives who have helped see to it that the class members of 1997 made it here tonight. So congratulations once again to all of you for being here on stage tonight. And to the class of 1997, I have a short message for you. This evening, the message I have is entitled, Dreams to Reality. Tonight I stand before you to remind you that you are closing one of your important chapters in your lives, that of your high school education. For some of you, it's 13 and one half years, while others may be only 12 or 13 and one half years. Are now complete, but with this ending comes a new beginning. A new chapter of your lives will be written as you pursue your individual goals after the ceremony here this evening. Yet, no matter what path you choose to follow, a few general ideas apply to all of you. Perhaps as you ponder the numerous choices made available to you, you probably feel overwhelmed. But once you make the first choice, the others will fall right into place. Do not be afraid that you have made a bad choice, because the only bad choice you can make is not to decide at all. Indecision is a true waste of talent. By putting off a decision, precious time is lost and can never be replaced. Whereas even a choice that proves to be an error can work as a direction for future decision making. Having a wish or a dream provides you with a focal point on which to center on your lives and a direction in which to move. A dream not only serves to inspire you, it can direct you in a productive path that will lead to your success. There is an important difference between a dream and a wish. The difference lies in the way you pursue them. A wish is as elusive as you want to fulfill that wish, but often feel you do not have the means to complete it. Therefore, it lies in your mind, never getting the opportunity to nurture or to grow like an unplanted seed. A dream, on the other hand, is an idea that you set before yourselves. You pursue and strive to obtain it. Like a seed, the sooner the dream is planted, the more time it has to mature, thus the decision made sooner has more time to mature and blossom into reality. You cannot succeed or find happiness until you know what it is you want to accomplish. Make your high school education here at Portage Area work to your advantage. You must learn to use your education for the advancement of our society, since education is the foundation and framework our great nation was built on. As you should recognize the importance of an education, you need to focus the attention of people everywhere on the importance of education as the backbone of our great nation. Now, as you move into the next stage of your life, you must believe that you have been given every opportunity for a reason to succeed and to make the best of it. Learn as much as you can from all your experiences. Never let an event go by without extracting a bit of knowledge from it to improve your way of life as well as the world around you. You should always remember that it is your individual growth and understanding that you develop character. And with character, you can shape the world you live in. As our forefathers had a dream to make public education a reality, you should depart from this stage tonight with a dream of your own. A dream to use your education for the improvement of yourselves and the advancement of the world around us. To each and every one of the graduates, I extend my congratulations. May your guiding light take you down the path of success. Once again, congratulations, thank you, and God bless you. It is now my pleasure to present the class of 1997 on behalf of the administrators and faculty to the Board of School Directors for graduation. Will the board members please prepare to confer the diplomas? And will the senior class prepare to graduate? Would Brian Waxmunsby please come forward? Congratulations. Would you please call the roll?
All right, thank you.
Board members presenting the plaques tonight, the diplomas, are Mr. Dino Skarden, Mrs. Huff, and I apologize, I don't know you. I'm sorry. The graduates, Julia Ann Costin. Kyle John Onderko. Amy Beth Cadwalder. Anne Marie Rank. Sarah Jean Cattell. Alicia Dawn Handel. Claire Jeanette Wagner. Rico Oishi. Nicole Marie Bednarski. Jennifer Koningsberg. William R. Hill, Jr. Helen Schultz. Sean Coonrod. Tracy Lynn Serbian. Alan Joseph Dubreck. Jared Anthony Vina. Charlotte L. Thornton. I apologize. News bulletin. The other board member is Mr. Donald Hazlett. Theodore Dustin Raycar. Timothy Stephen Ennedy. Eric Scott White. Matthew Raymond Hodge. Tony Marie Koningsberg. William Yanger. Nikki Lindsay Samantic. Matthew Wayne Elshin. Kelly Lee Bolvin. John Charles Guidus. Heather Lynn Moyer. Matthew Brian Cafasso. Adrian Marie Feathers. Matthew Paul Gentile. Julia Sylvia Fields. Jesse Lynn Lightsinger. Victoria Yingling. Thomas George. Jennifer Beth Vrabel. Matthew Lewis Cordish. Heather E. Roberts. Gregory A. Pedrosky. Sheila Marie Ennedy. Samuel E. Stevens. Cassandra Marie Frommel. Sean T. Smith. Lisa Marie Lytle. I heard you. Michael Thomas Berta. Carrie L. Shepherd. Jeremy J. Burkett. Lisa Voss. Justin Kissel. Krista Butherbaugh. Christopher J. Barno. Shirley Jaddick. Shane Burkheimer. Tracy Roberts. Jannard Reed. Janine Molnar. Matthew Mayers. Erica Marie Just. Jim Kick. Kara Kreisberger. Clayton Lloyd. Melissa Lysinger. John Panic. Shannon Ritz. Larry Allen Rudick. Jennifer Lynn Borley. Jason Wayne Clinton. Alicia Marie Nickel. D. David Michael Sikriski. Stacy Jean Bolden. John William Raycar. Krista Lynn Vassis. Jamie Herman. Jamie Marie Krischko. Michael S. Steele. Melissa Ann Brown. Barry Joe George. Melinda McEwen. Garrett Sweeney. Amber Champ. Brett Robine. Jamie Lynn Kissel. Jonathan Zunich. Solitaire Ann Shepherd. Richard Haney. Lisa Rochelle Baer. Adam Rudolph Bolton. Stacy Lynn Costin. Joseph Anthony Archie. Brianne Lee Rogers.
That's a long name.
Christopher Stanley Kaputska.
Hi.
Brianna Lee Shope. Justin Michael Ferrero. Craig Thomas Somalia. Aaron Scott Milius. Thaddeus John Tutsoff. John Ronan.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Secretary of Education and the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania to serve as superintendent of the Portage Area School District, I now declare you individuals graduates of the Portage Area High School with all the rights and privileges and honors attached hereto. Congratulations.
Please remain standing. Yes, Anne Rank, this is my daughter. I'll get killed. She is some of the precious gold in my life. To the class of 1997, I say congratulations. In this small container, there are some things that are almost tiny, virtually unseen most of our lives. They are seeds. And these seeds, even though we don't see them very often, we see what they do, we see what they produce. When planted, watered, nurtured, some will become flowers, some vegetables. Some will become weeds from which we will get medicine. Some will become fruit trees, some lumber trees from which we will derive numerous byproducts. Each of you as graduates have many similar seeds in you, seeds of knowledge and experience, seeds of hope and joy, seeds of peace and love, seeds that hold the promise of becoming all that God has gifted you for and all that God is guiding you to be. Please nurture and water these seeds, even as you've already begun to this night, with tears of sorrow and tears of joy. Always strive to live and grow in the knowledge of the Lord. And now, graduates, parents, families, friends, I send you from this place into the next chapter of your life. Please go knowing that the best is yet to come. And go knowing and enjoying and sharing the blessings of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. I pray the God of grace and peace, the God of mercy and love, be with you now and always. Amen.
Thank you.
Don't want to get in the middle of the camera.
We're back into the jungle.
You're out of here. Hey, nice green shades, hey, man.
I know. I'm always color coded.
It's so funny.
Hey, you made it. Very good. Peeked out the mic. Hi.
Hi.
Good job.
Thank you very much. Nope, I still don't have a watch.
Yeah, that's the one.
Hey, this is a 2-hour tape.
I think you're
You can put Clemson in there or anything you want.
Yeah, I can put anything in there I want.
What's your name?
Yeah, well.
Hi there, how are you? Good job. Hi guys, how are you doing? New haircut, eh? Looking sharp. Ready to go.
Yeah.
Where are you going?
Like, where'd you get those shades at?
What's that?
Where'd you get those shades?
Oh, I can't tell you that.
Oh, awesome.
I like them.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
How about you, dude? Did you copy off him or is he copying off you?
No, he's copying off me.
Finally.
Not me. And where's yours?
I didn't wear.
You're hanging out with these guys. But is this like the Shade Cortel here? Very good. That's better. Synchronized in doing this? Who's going to start it? You? Somebody's got to start. Somebody's got to pull the first one, you know?
I will.
You got, you're elected?
I'll be the rebel.
Okay, say goodbye.
Bye.
Hey, man.
Hey, man. Hey, man. Who's who? This? This is your class video. How are you?
Well, in 10 years.
There you go. 10 years. Why? Why 10 years?
If we even lived that long.
Well, stranger things have happened.
Well, where's the phone? Where are you going?
Can you get out of here?
Hi, how are you?
Hey, we have a big point.
We're ready. All right. Hello, Mr. Cameraman. How are you doing?
How are we doing, guys?
Pretty good. I must say you're doing an excellent job.
There you go.
No one's
at work. Hey, no, none tonight. How are you? Sounds good. Sounds good.
That's the plan.
That's what it's all about. Is that what we're discussing here?
That's what we're discussing right now.
Okay.
We didn't realize we were talking to you, actually.
You're talking to yourself. This is your class video. This is your class.
This is our class.
Who's the class of 97? Are they number one?
This is our foreign exchange student.
Who, we're from where?
Olo. Where do you think?
Olo.
No. He means Olio. His English isn't too good.
Oh, yeah. Olio. He's from Olio.
He means Hungary. His English is really bad.
Sir, last
right.
I mean, he is directly after this.
These shoes are killers.
Ready?
get that, Scott. Big payoff.
That's nice.
Great shot.
I think it's my client.
Yeah.
There you go. Thank you.
I just chose up on everyone.
Very good.
I just saw him walking.
Hey, Ready? Tickets. How about that?
Did you get a ticket?
Huh?
Do you have one?
Yeah, right here.
No, that's not.
Let's see the program.
I think that'll work.
Ooh la la.
Thank you. Yep.
Are you in the book? Are you in the book? Is your name in the book? Are you graduating, dear?
Yeah.
And your name's in the book, right?
Yeah. Okay. I thought that was a trick question.
Okay. Say goodbye. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Back. That's better. Much better. Wait.
Again.
You got posies already.
Yes, I'm in the book.
Wow. Hey, she didn't even do anything yet. How's she going? You got posies. Okay, that'll work. Turn them around. Let's see.
Turn them around.
Yeah, very nice.
Okay. With flowers.
Lovely. Just lovely. Aren't they lovely?
Yes, they are.
Yes, they are.
Amen.
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 Right. Now, with our doctor can tell with our positive attitude this morning. Here we got Mr. Yet to go outside. We're going to learn what life is all about.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise
the Lord.
Amen.
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 Praise the Lord.
We're going to go out to our trade schools, technical schools. We're going to go out to our hotels, our wives, children, what have you.
Children.
Yeah.
You.
Look back today and remember
Send it, go in peace. Let's have a mass and bring it in. Bring it in.
Bring it in.
What are we saying?
We're
going to
sing.
Yeah.
Oh.
Do something.
Right.
What are we going to say? You say.
Amen. Hallelujah. Portage rolls like, on three.
No.
Amen. Class 97.
Let me try on your
one. Class 97. One, two, three.
Class 97.